Welcome back, guys. So in the last video I talked about the motion of planets and motion of satellites around a planet and the other concepts, and finally I talked about the time period of revolution and the frequency, right? So if you are not well versed with those, I invite you to watch those videos and come back here. So in this video I'll talk about another concept, which is the energy of a satellite. Now, in the case of escape velocity, I explained to you what is the energy of some object under gravity, right? So energy of some object under gravity is equal to the summation of the kinetic energy and the potential energy. So here is the same. So energy of a satellite, or the total energy of an orbiting satellite, can be written as the sum of kinetic energy and the gravitational potential energy. Alright, so the topic is energy of a satellite. So the total energy of an orbiting satellite can be written as the sum of the kinetic energy and the gravitational potential energy. So if I take the total energy to be ET is equal to EK, is the kinetic energy, and EP, so EP is equal to the gravitational potential energy. So the total energy of the satellite is equal to the total kinetic energy and the total potential energy. Alright, so we know the values of these two. We can substitute to find the value of ET. We can solve this, right? We can simplify this, right? So that it will be easy for any problem we are facing under gravity about the energy of a satellite and energy of not even a satellite, energy of any object, right? So we can derive a simple equation, right? Simple derivation, right? From the theories we have learned so far under the series of videos on gravity. So the kinetic energy of the satellite, you know that is equal to half times its mass. I'll take the mass to be m times the square of the velocity. So I'll take the orbital velocity as in the last video to be v naught. So it will be v naught square, right? So that's the kinetic energy plus the potential energy. Potential energy is equal to, if the mass of the object or the mass of the satellite is simple m, and the mass at which this object is rotating is capital M, say, and a satellite is rotating around the Earth, the mass of the Earth is capital M and the mass of the satellite is simple m, and the distance between the center of the mass of the Earth and the satellite is r, you can say that the potential energy is minus g times capital M and simple m divided by r. So that I explained in another video under gravitational potential energy. So if you are not well versed with gravitational potential energy, I invite you to watch that video and come back here. Alright, so we can simplify this. So how we can simplify this? How we can simplify this is that we found the value of V naught in the previous video. We found the value of V naught to be Gm by R. V naught equals root Gm by R. So V naught squared, we actually found V naught from V naught squared. So V naught squared we found it to be Gm divided by R. So we can find the substitute the value of V naught to be Gm by R, and we can simplify this. So this is half times M times Gm by R, plus times negative is negative. So this will be G times capital M simple m by r. So this will be, you can take g times capital M times simple m by r out, you can take it out, right? So half will be remaining here and minus 1 will be remaining here. So half minus 1 is minus half, that multiplied by this one will be, so the total energy of the satellite, or the total energy of any object that is revolving or rotating or moving under gravity around another object, whether it's the Earth or any other planet, will be minus g times capital M and simple m divided by r, right? So this will be minus g times capital M divided by simple m divided by r. So again, this value minus represents that this energy is due to the Earth's or the any other planet's gravitational field. That means that the work is done by the external agent, not by the force itself or not by the object itself. So the energy is minus. So this is not due to some energy loss, energy change, due to some collision or something, or any other chemical reaction or physical reaction that is taking place inside the subject. The value of minus is actually due to, we can conclude that the value of minus is actually due to the force of attraction or the force of the gravity, right? Is due to the external agent's work, and we get a value of minus here. So the total energy of the satellite is minus g times, this is 2r, right? 2r. Right? I forgot that. 2r, sir, right? So it is equal to minus g times capital M times simple m divided by 2r. So the minus value is due to the work done by the external agent. So let's calculate a simple example. I'll take the value of g to be g, and the mass of the Earth, mass of an object to be 5 kilograms, and the mass of the object that is revolving around this 5 kilograms to be 2 kilograms, and the distance between these two objects to be 4 meters. So we have been given that g is g, right? So m is equal to 5 kilograms. These are just arbitrary values, right? And this m, simple m, is equal to 2 kilograms, and r is equal to 4 meters. So you can see, you can find value of et. So et is equal to minus g times capital M, which is 5 kilograms, times a simple m, which is 2 kilograms, divided by 2 times r, which is 4 meters. So that will be equal to 5 times 2 is 10. So this 2 will be cancelled with this 2, right? So this will be 5g by 4 minus 1.25g, and this is an energy, so its unit will be joules, right? I'll take it as joules, right? Because these are in SI units, it can't be calorie or any other unit. Since these are in SI units, the value should be joules. So its the total kinetic energy of this satellite will be minus 1.25g joules. So that is a simple example, and the derivation of the energy of a satellite and the other concepts on basis as to how we can get that. On the basis we have learned so far, using the value of V naught we found in the last video, and the energy conservation we found in mechanics, and that's about the energy of a satellite. So in the next video I'll be talking about another topic of gravity, and that will sometimes probably be the last video on the series of videos on gravity. And thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you then.